Back now to our top story, O.J. Simpson, the phone call. He called in during a live discussion on Fox News Channel this afternoon. We were talking about lie detector tests and whether Simpson himself once took a partial test and was failing. With us, his late wife's sister, Denise Brown, and the polygrapher, whom attorneys in Simpson's trial alleged administered that test.
I'm only calling for one reason, because you are a liar. Mr. Gibb will tell you, I've never met this man. If I met him, he's in a social environment, and you're telling America he did some tests for me?
No, I think, let's settle it real easily, O.J.
I just heard you a second ago.
Wait now.
Say, Mr. Gibb met him, he said he never took a test.
Mr. Simpson?
And plus, Mr. Gibb will tell you, there is no way on earth that a person in the middle of a lie detector test, that somebody can tell if they're filling it or not filling a lie detector test.
Mr. Simpson,
if he's hooked up, it's impossible to do that.
Mr. Simpson?
Ask Mr. Gelb the pertinent questions. Stop giving bogus information. Mr. Gelb, ask him, has he ever met me?
Mr. Simpson, here's the problem. Mr. Gelb says he has an attorney-client privilege relationship with you.
Ask Mr. Gelb, I'm saying this.
And as
that's
result,
a dangerous...
He says that he can't answer that question because
Why?
He has an attorney-client privilege relationship with you. Would you release
okay,
him from
well,
that attorney-client privilege?
Okay, but I'm just saying that you guys talking about Mr. Gelb was in some room with me and said that he can't answer it, to my knowledge.
Well, that's shocking. He wasn't.
Mr. Gelb may have been in a social environment.
Let's close
I don't recall ever meeting him outside of a social environment.
So
to
what
my
you're saying,
knowledge, he was in Europe.
Mr. Simpson?
The week of Nicole's death. So I don't know what you're giving.
Well, I appreciate you calling him.
I've heard you twice, sir. Say to your audience that O.J. testified that he was with Mr. Gelb somewhere. To my knowledge, I've never met Mr. Gelb, and I know I've never said I was with Mr. Gelb anyway. Plus, Mr. Gelb will confirm to you that it's impossible for somebody observing a lie detector test to be able to tell if a guy is lying in the middle of a lie detector test.
Mr. Gelb, he says...
O.J. is correct in regards to that. In other words, if there was somebody who was not the examiner or the person being examined, there would be no way they could determine until the end of the examination
right.
whether the person was truthful or deceptive.
Mr. Simpson, it's you know, if you were never hooked up and asked questions on a lie detector test, now's the time to get it straight. Were you
well,
ever hooked up or not?
You know, some people are doing charity. Denise made her statement. Denise's parents have spent many times at charitable events that I've created for Kids with Cancer Camp, Good Times. I spent my life doing work for Boys Club of America. Before this happened, I think I was one of the most giving guys in America. So for Denise to say I'm a conniving person because I gave her sister a surprise party. Denise is the only liar here. It's coming out that the money that they get, none of it goes to charity. Denise was on welfare. She had no
Mr.
job.
Mr. Simpson, let me ask you one quick question.
About being working for
O.J.?
Look at her. Tell her I'll put up all of my IRS statements. Let's see what kind of job she had
Mr. Simpson,
before this happened.
For a second, O.J., just one quick question, if you don't mind, O.J. Mr. Simpson, Ms. Cox was on the line with us just a moment ago and said that, in fact, you were going to have this pay-per-view event. Tell me about that.
It ain't
that.
A pay-per-view. It's American. Some people came to me. They asked me, would I be willing to come on to speak to the public. Well, mm-hmm. I've always wanted to speak to the public because of people like you who give bogus information all the time to the public about things I reputedly have stated or said. Nobody could ever tell you I've ever mentioned Mr. Gelb's name anywhere, let alone in a court of law. You've told your audience twice this, and you tried to make some comparison between, well, he said he wasn't hooked up, Mr. Gelb can't do this, and I mean, I don't know why you guys do this.
Well,
if you want to talk to me directly,
well, here we
on
go.
publiccrossing.com, they came to me. Actually, a lady came to me whose son was who was paralyzed, who's
O.J., let's get it all straight right
she
here.
She asked me,
you know, here's
would
the discrepancy.
Be willing to do this
O.J.,
with some
O.J.,
of her if they can have money go
O.J.,
to their charity.
Here's
and I said, yes. I also would like to send some money to the Innocence Project
okay.
because
O.J.?
They're constantly getting people out of jail who we now know is innocent, people who are on death row that were convicted of crimes.
Right.
Not like me who weren't convicted of anything, that were convicted on crimes because the police did whatever they did to convict them. Now we know they're innocent.
O.J.,
well, I like to see people like that get a second chance. The person who's made the most money, and they have improved their lifestyle the most out of Nicole's death, is Denise Brown. She ain't on welfare
Excuse
anymore.
Me.
She's
Excuse
got a job
me.
Now. That's
I have
all I
always
got to
had
say.
A job.
Good night. Tune in. Hey, Denise, I'll put up all of my credit cards. I'll put up all of my charitable work. I'll show them all my IRS statements before Nicole's murder. You do the same. I challenge you to do the same. Let's see who's benefited.
I want to get one thing straight before you hang up the phone, though, because this thing with Ethel Bailey is really confusing to me, O.J. He says that you took a polygraph test and you weren't passing it and that Robert Shapiro threw the results away. What really happened?
Well, that's not true, and I don't think Lee said that. Here's what I don't get. Why don't you guys ever put up Lee's statement? Put it up in writing. Anytime you think something works against me, you put it up in writing. Now, if you look at what Lee said, he didn't say that. He told them, I was at a place, I was deciding if I was going to do a lie detector test or not. When it was over, that same day, we wrote a letter to the DA and Marshall Clark in writing. I will do a lie detector test for the police. I don't care if they did it or who did it.
Okay, you're saying you'll do a lie detector test.
I would do one for them,
OJ?
Only if the results would be submitted in any future litigation. The police said no. Marsha Clark said no. So
what about now, OJ?
More about it than anybody.
Would you take a lie detector test now?
Not for you, I won't.
But how about for Mr. Gelb? How about for the FBI?
Hey, if I can benefit for it, I will. If I can benefit, if Denise and Goldman and all those guys think I'm guilty, hey, sign off. They say whatever money's made, OJ can keep to raise his kids. Hey, I'll do it. Otherwise, I'm not going to be. You know that nanny? You know the nanny passed 3 lie detector tests. You know what? They still prosecuted her. You know the Ramses went on. They passed a lie detector test. You know what happened? Nobody believes it,
Mr. Bailey.
You know. So if I'm not going to benefit, I'm not going to be some dancing monkey for you guys.
OJ, Mr. Bailey
says you couldn't pass it to begin with. What makes you think you could pass it now?
Sign off. Simple. Sign off. Tell me I can
what
keep
makes
the money
you think
make
you could pass it now? You murdered Nicole, and you know you did it. And, you know, I mean, you're just amazing. And
no, you
what
you
have you what have you ever
same.
Given
you're
me,
so
OJ? You've
Everybody
never given
you
me
know,
a
Nicole
damn
kept her friends
penny.
From you
not
because
one
you were
thing.
Screwing all her friends. You know it, and I know it.
You know
Ask
what?
Nicole's
you are a pig. You are a low life, no good
Why?
Son of a gun.
Ask Nicole's best friends.
You know what?
All these people, even Faye Rusnick, why Nicole kept all of her friends away from Denise?
OJ, how can you put her
oh,
through
please.
This?
Oh, please, what are you doing?
Don't ask me. Go to Faye Rusnick. Go to
she's a real
ask
close friend,
why
isn't she?
Nicole kept all of her new friends away from Denise. Asked.
OJ, you know, you're
it.
Pathetic.
You guys ask. No, you're
you
pathetic.
You are pathetic.
No, you and Fred Goldman. I never go on TV. I avoid the media as much as I can. They chase me. You guys, if it's a door opening, you guys are showing up.
OJ,
to put your faces
OJ,
on
excuse
TV
me, OJ,
so you can make money.
But Lee
you're
Bailey.
The only person that's benefited from this, Denise. You and Fred Goldman.
What have
OJ,
I done,
excuse
OJ?
Me, just for
you made
a second.
Money. You're not on welfare
Where?
Anymore.
OJ, I want to get to the bottom.
You don't live at home with your... You were living at home with your family, a burden on your mother and father.
OJ, wait
Nicole
now. This is making me
money.
Uncomfortable, if you don't mind.
Mr. Raise you and your son.
Mr. Simpson.
And since Nicole's
Mr.
Death,
Simpson.
You're on your own.
You never gave me a penny, OJ.
No, your family got money from
you
me.
You never gave me
your
a penny.
Your family got
you
money
You are
for
the
you.
Only one. You and I, we didn't get along. We didn't get along because you couldn't control me. That's
oh,
why
that,
we don't
I didn't get along because Nicole was afraid you were going to have sex with me.
Oh,
that's
please.
Why we didn't get along. It was Nicole that told
oh,
me to
Oh, please,
stay
your
away
ego
from
is just really riding a little bit too high, Simpson.
Mr.
Your
Simpson,
ego
I want
is just a little bit too big.
Why don't I ask all of my friends about what I just said?
Just a little bit too big.
Why don't I go from Bobby Sandler, who's
big.
Dead now, to Ahmad, to AC, to Marcus? Why don't I go to Ed McKay? What? Why don't I go to all of my friends, Denise?
Mr. Simpson?
And ask them, is it true
Simpson,
or not?
Simpson, you are
Oh, you didn't
pig.
Have a relationship with every one of them.
Mr. Simpson, just a moment.
Okay,
Mr.
I'm sorry, but you guys get on TV.
Mr. Simpson, your lawyer,
whole,
Mr. Bailey.
I don't call a debate with Denise. It's you that I got a problem with.
Mr. Simpson.
And it's you why I don't do network TV.
Mr. Simpson.
Because you give facts that are not true.
Well, here, let's clear up one more, Mr. Simpson. Mr.
If you
Bailey.
Want to keep me on the line,
Mr. Simpson.
Replay what you said earlier in the show about Gavin.
Mr. Simpson, Mr. Bailey says that you have, that he has come to you with this $3 million deal to do a polygraph and you turned it down. Is that true?
I don't know if that's true or not because I haven't talked to Lee since he went on the show. The first I heard of that was when Lee was on the show.
So
I will do a lie detector test if I can get the money.
But
other than that, you have to tune in on publiccrossing.com. I'm not getting paid a dime.
Well, tell me what happens to the money there. It all goes to charity, right?
I don't know what they're doing with the money. I don't work for the company that's doing this.
Would
it's
you allow?
Like if I go, is your money by having Denise?
What about this,
and Mary
Mr.
Cox
Simpson? Would you be willing
calling in? Is the money from this show going all to charity?
Mr. Simpson, would you be willing to allow that .com
well, the money
project
from
to happen,
this show all
and then
to
allow
charity.
And then allow for some of that money to go to your civil lawsuit, none of which has been
Why?
Paid
for what?
The
they
civil
knew
lawsuit?
I had no money when they took me into a civil lawsuit. They had all of my records. I have never been in trouble with the IRS, ever. They had all my records.
But that wasn't the question.
They saw what my money was.
That wasn't
the question. And they made major points about this isn't about money. Well, since the trial, all I hear is money. That's all I hear.
Well, there is a $33 million.
And the only reason I've called in your show now, not to get in a debate with Denise, I know how Denise feels about me. She knows how I feel about her. And she also knows how her sister felt about her. I'm calling you because you are the ones. You see, facts and fiction? What you said earlier in this show, sir, is all fiction. Ed Gelb will tell you the same thing.
Okay, Mr. Simpson, you it said on the stand during your trial that you were hooked up to the machine to demonstrate to you how it worked. Is that still
true? Yeah, because I wanted to be able to say to LAPD I would do one, which
right.
I did, and they didn't accept it.